Well, we're back in the shop. Some of you guys are probably wondering how the old Dodge 6.7 Cummins job went with that fuel contamination. I didn't film any of the work, but basically we pushed it in here, thawed the truck out, then ripped up the wooden planking on the flatbed, and that allowed us access to the top of the fuel tank in the back, and pulled the sending unit slash pump out, and the fuel was just green, algae, nasty junk. That's when you know it's good diesel. And then pumped all that out, found an inch thick of ice in the bottom of the tank, broke all the ice out, got all the ice cleaned out of the tank, wiped the tank out real good, flushed the fuel lines, filled the tank back up with fresh fuel and a bunch of additives in there, brand new fuel filter on the motor. And after that, she fired right up and ran like a top. So got that thing taken care of. She's going down the road again, happy. So another job knocked out and out of the way. Anyways, the reason we're in here now, I got some new toys to show off to you guys. So basically one of the local shops here in town, they're cleaning stuff up and making room and phasing out some of their ancient shop equipment so they can upgrade and get better set up. So they hit me up and they were like, hey, we got this old stuff. We don't really want to throw it out. You think you can make any good use of it and give it a good home? I said, heck yeah, bring it over. So here's what they set me up with. First off, we've got a vintage Black & Decker. I believe it's from the 1950s. Valve grinding machine. And this is awesome because I've been after a valve grinder for quite a while now, ever since I learned how to use one. And see how handy they can be when you're messing with old stuff like I do. So it's a belt drive system. Basically, it acts like a drill. You can chuck up your valve in there and then grind your valve surfaces on this stone. And then over here, they make attachments, which I have some of them, that slide into here. You can lock those down, and then you can grind your face of your lifters and your valve stems on the side of this stone. So that's pretty cool. And of course, this machine needs desperately cleaned up from sitting around not being used for probably 30 plus years. But when I first got it, these would barely turn, so I popped open all the oiler caps and oiled everything up, and now she's already coming back around, working smoothly again. So there's your adjustment for grinding. And then here's your depth in and out on that. But they work smooth again, so that's awesome that they're coming back around. And definitely old by just how vintage the plug is. I mean, look at that thing. But yeah, so you got your attachments for that side, which is what some of this is all about. Now this is for dressing up your stones. Basically, it fits in here like so, and it's got a diamond tip on it, and you just run that across the stone when it gets worn unevenly or loaded up with a bunch of material. You can just dress up your stone like so. And then this is for dressing your seat stones, and that's what all these are. Now, they make all these different size stones for doing valve seats in the head, and of course there's different angle cuts and so on and so forth. I don't have near as much options as there are, but enough to get started at least. And then these are pilots. Your pilots fit down in your valve guide on the head, and those pilots actually guide the stone so it can center itself on the seat and properly grind the seat. And then all your stones screw onto these things. And basically the main thing I'm missing is an electric drill slash driver looking thing with a hex on it. And you stick that hex down into this thing that's got whatever stone you need. And then you just hold it, run that drill, and that's what grinds your valve seats in the head. So that's what all the different size stones and pilots are for, is for the head work side of the valve train. But yeah, got enough here to get started. Then we've got this vintage flathead spring compressor tool, so that's pretty neat. And then of course, all the valve lapping tools with the suction cups for lapping valves. So that's pretty much the whole setup on the valve grinder here. I did plug it in. The electric motor's working everything. The only thing I did not plug in is this pump back here. Now, basically, this is a little unit that holds oil, whether it be motor oil, ATF, or whatever you use. Usually, it's ATF from what I was taught. But it's got these hoses here that plug on like so, and this little unit just hangs by a bracket back there, so it's easily removable, and it plugs into the back of the main machine here. So when you turn like this switch on, it powers this and the pump at the same time, so you're not having to use multiple outlets for stuff. But everything up here works. Plugged it in, works fine. Gonna wait to plug in the pump until I tear this all apart and clean it up. It desperately needs that, along with new hoses. But basically what this little thing's job is to supply oil to these tubes up here. And then, of course, you got a shield here to kind of keep it from slinging back out, and it can drain back. But that's to pump oil up here and apply lubrication to your grinding. So, pretty neat setup, how it can just drain back into the tank and keep cycling. And never seen the guard on one before, so that's kind of neat. But she's a cool little machine. It's not something a lot of people do anymore, grinding valves and whatnot, because nowadays you can just buy a whole pre-assembled head from Summit, you know, aluminum heads with the valves and springs and everything all in it. Or you can just buy brand new valves, but in reality, even when valves go bad, just grind them, grind your seats and everything and put them back together. I actually did that on my 360 FE and my Red 71 Highboy. When I overhauled that motor, I used a friend's valve grinder, and he taught me how to grind valves and everything. So I ground all my own valves, ground all my own seats and the heads, and brought her back to life, basically, and just did a full-on valve train job and didn't have to buy all new components, which, you know, why replace when you can just keep making it work with a little bit of effort? Looking at the old data tags are pretty cool. I don't see a date on any of them, but I'm pretty sure this thing's from the 1950s. Just looking at stuff online, but maybe somebody on here can correct me. Black & Decker actually had a matching cabinet that these things would sit on. So a paint match red cabinet with doors in the front, and it was on wheels. I don't have that, obviously, but I brought this thing in here and just set it on this shop cart that I have. And it fits it a little too perfectly. It's like the right height, and you know, it's got the shelves and everything and just the right size. So I think the cart is this thing's new home for now until I build something else. Or maybe even find a matching cabinet for it to go on. That'd be pretty cool. But for now, the old cart will work just fine. Moving on here, we've got this sweet little Kwik Way brake drum lathe, which is super neat because most of these machines that I've seen, they take up like an entire wall space, and they're never this compact or tiny. But don't let its size fool you. That thing is almost boom truck rated because that thing's heavy. So is the valve grinder, but that thing takes the cake for being heavy. It's a nice little setup. I don't have many attachments for it. Those guys said they were still going through stuff and can probably hook me up with more attachments. So that'd be awesome. But yeah, something else I've kind of been after for a while now is a brake drum lathe. You know, because the stuff I mess with, you know, you can't always find brake drums for them, or they've still got life in them, so why buy a new one when you can just turn it down and make it a good surface again? So basically, you've got your lathe bit here, and you can loosen this up and position the lathe part to whatever size drum you're working with. But I did plug this thing in. It works as well. Once again, needs thoroughly cleaned up from sitting around doing nothing forever. And needs everything lubed up because, well, you know, it's kind of seized. But the electric portion does work, so that's awesome. And what a nice little machine to just, you know, build like a little cart or stand for. And it's compact. It doesn't take up much room. And That'd be really exciting to be able to do drum work as well. All this valve grinding stuff is going to come in super handy for the Flathead Revival project, as well as future projects too. But as you guys know, I've got all the valves out of this one, and they all need gone through and cleaned up and ground, as do the seats. So I'll have to go through all my stuff there and see if I've got the right size pilots to fit these guides and the right size stones for doing the seats. And if I don't, I'll have to either borrow some or buy some. Of course, it wouldn't hurt to own more with this type of work anyway. So that'll be sweet. We'll have the full setup for taking care of this, and I won't have to transport it to the valve grinder that my friend has, and should be able to do it here. So yeah, I just wanted to show you guys this new stuff. It's pretty fun messing with the old shop equipment and seeing it work. Just goes to show how great this stuff was built to last back in the day. I mean, you plug either one of these in, they just work right off the bat. So with a little bit of cleanup and TLC action, I see no reason why they wouldn't continue to last from here on out. So some great toolage here. Really appreciate it. Really appreciate those guys in town taking the time to think that, hey, somebody might be able to use this stuff. Let's find them a home rather than throw them out and let them go to waste. So, you know, for people like me that mess with the old stuff, that's really appreciated. So big thanks to them. And yeah, I guess until I start messing with them and cleaning things up and making sure everything works, stay tuned for future videos on them. And definitely stay tuned for the valve grinding action, because it's definitely going to get featured in the Flathead Revival series. So keep an eye out for that. You'll get to see how the valve grinding process works. It's pretty cool. So yeah, till I mess with them some more, thanks for watching. And till the next video, I'll see you guys later.